We are back with Building Syracuse. We're here in week one, our second. We will be playing our second game here in a little bit against Miami, starting ACC playoff early. Recap, we did the offseason. We had some issues with the schedule because the game glitched and was broken. We couldn't get the schedule we wanted. We had to play Notre Dame. We beat them. It worked out well. It worked out in our favor. We go 1-0. We get our first quote-unquote, don't know if I want to call it a landmark win. I mean, we didn't have too many great, Miami was our toughest opponent last year until we had played Michigan and we lost that game. So we get our win against Notre Dame, get our win against a good program, marquee program, and now we play number 14 Miami. Today I want to get through week one against Miami, and then week two against leave UConn. Team schedule. For those of you who might need the memory jog, we had Notre Dame at Miami. Then we have UConn, then travel to Clemson, then Pitt, and then FCS, Midwest, North Texas, and a neutral site game against Tennessee, bye week, Georgia at Georgia Tech, bye week, Boston College, SMU, Duke. SMU and then Duke, end the season. That's kind of how things will work. Before we play the game, let's get into recruiting. Our four-star quarterback John Anelli is not very interested. We have Taylor Wilson who is. So let's have a lot of that's why we don't. So I guess we'll stay on DM the player because we won't have enough for that. We don't have much in the way of quarterback situations right now. I'm very curious on what we're going to get with Taylor Wilson and Miles Good. I'd like some good on the team. So, kind of see what we get, even though... Oh, wait, we have that. Okay, so let's see. Anelli, have I really done anything with Anelli? No. Isaac, okay. I'm gonna pull back on send the house for now. Maybe we can start learning a little bit about Ben Isaac as we're competing with Penn State there. Matt Griffin, I'm not too... even though he's supposedly the bust, we will do some research on Mr. Matt Griffin. Yeah, I guess we're gonna offer him a scholarship because I hit a button. Wilson, let's see. We can do there. We don't have a lot of hours sitting around right now. Robert Sharp we got locked out of, so we can take him off the board. We got 5-star Dennis Yeast who... We got locked out here of Eric Light and Javier Gage. We missed a couple five stars. Terrence Hippenhammer. We're sitting third right now with him. Alec October, we're sitting fifth. We're getting there though. Anybody that we're super interested in isn't super interested in us. We've thrown some hours in that we can. Let's see. I don't even know where I want to go. Get some of our hours there just to come down and see if we can. Need to come up five more hours somewhere. Just see if we can get on Dennis Yeast's board. If it doesn't work, we're gonna look. I mean, it's not the end of the world. What's happening outside? Hold, please. We traveled to South Beach, Hard Rock Stadium. Match up. What can we put Miami in for home? For a matchup against the Miami Hurricanes. Get the big game crew, and we will be kicking off, and this will be a touchback, no return. I don't know who Miami's Judd Anderson, freshman from Gray, Georgia, leads out the U. Aiden Davis did good in our first game against Notre Dame, man in motion, hop pass, and a gain of four for.
Too much, but he's got the talent, and now he's gonna have to earn the respect of everybody around him.
Solid pickup up to the 29.
Anderson wants to throw.
Anderson throwing. Completed. First down.
And they'll spot it at the 38, and that'll be plenty for the first down. And now a fresh set of downs for this
offense. Fireworks are very annoying.
Wide receiver shows motion. They'll give it to the back.
When Bellamy makes... Oh, please. Loss of two. Deuce Chestnut on the tackle. Thank God. Jaden Bellamy, who blew through into the field. In motion. Another touch pass. Brought down. Loss of one. Deuce Chestnut again.
So a lot of recruiting, Jesse, on other people's teams that go on throughout a season.
Yeah, it's 365, and it's a lot of pressure.
Third and 13.
To re-recruit their own players as well to try to keep those rosters intact. But the transfer portal completely flips rosters upside down.
One and dropped.
This year, if they get one key addition,
and it's going to be a punt.
It's a team potentially competing for a national championship next season.
And the Canes will call on their punt team.
Punt is up.
First look of the afternoon at the punter.
Fielded by Rourke. Rourke up to the 31. Freshman Terrence Rourke, who's really fast. We now have Justice Ross Simmons, our star receiver.
This is just a great matchup to watch on the outside and who can win downfield in the passing game.
Man, this reminds me of 1997, Charles Woodson versus David Boston.
And Hard Rock is rocking. As we have LaQuint Allen, our Heisman winner, in the backfield, taken down after a loss of two.
He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. After getting knocked back to open this drive, it's second and 12.
Braden Davis.
Quarterback flips it ahead quickly to the receiver.
Give it to Umari Hatcher. Umari Hatcher, first down. They went with a little jet pass or touch pass, jet touch pass. We go with it too, and we get the first down. Up to the 43. Davis hands off to Allen and loss of multiple, and Allen's already got wear and tear. Getting 14.
Davis looking to pass.
Davis passing to Clement and third and 8.
This is the kind of game, a top 25 matchup in the early season that you look for when you're trying to build your resume.
Yeah, these are so fun because as a player.
Davis to Dan Villari, who is still here. First down. 42.
All the adrenaline, all the juice.
Alex Yasan Willis in the backfield.
We've had this game circled for a long time because we learn a lot in these types of games. What are these teams about? Which conferences are better? You're going to get a lot of answers today.
And Justice Ross Simmons catch, first down, the 29.
Catch there, and they'll have enough for the first down. Fresh set of downs after the completion. The give from the gun.
On Willis, sophomore, his first carry of the game, game two.
Things did not go their way. This year, an opportunity maybe to turn things around.
And we've seen people in this league turn things around. The ACC every year, it seems like, you know, like Reese
motion.
Say, spinning that wheel of destiny. Who's going to be
and loss
game.
Of a couple.
It's not unheard of that you can have a bad season to turn around. So, Jesse, a lot of examples to point to as they kick off the season.
Yeah, it's critical then to get off to a fast start. They've got to come out here in their first conference game in ACC play and put it all together. Offense has to march the ball, score points. Defense needs to get some stops and create some takeaways.
Villari makes a move. First down and more. Up to the 17.
By both guys, the throw and the catch to work that defense and get the first down. This crowd knows when to bring it. They'll run it out of the shot.
Allen running. Touchdown, LaQuint Allen.
And he rolls into the house. Touchdown, Cuse.
Well, I know it's a very small sample size, and we've got a lot of football to go this year, but what can you say about this offense? How explosive and impressive have they looked? Top five in the nation in scoring, and you can see why. They've got speed and playmakers all over the field.
They'll try to add another to their lead.
Yeah, because up and good.
The extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. A 70-yard touchdown drive, and they finish it off with a 17-yard touchdown run.
Good. Those kick is deep. Deep and deeper. That's bad.
And they thought about a return, then thought better of it. They'll bring it out to the 25. Here comes the Hurricane offense looking to gather a little more strength. That last drive fizzled out, Jesse. They had to punt it.
Yeah, they did. And David, they're just going to have
first down and then some for Miami. Up to our 47.
Just trying to solve the defensive riddle, understanding what they're trying to do to you and attack them.
They'll snap
good throw from Anderson.
On first down. On the ground, it's Fletcher.
Fletcher, gain of four.
Solid gain before the defense bottles him up.
And that's a really nice play. It's impressive. When it's first down and the defense thinks you might be running the football, you still can line up. You get some movement at the point.
Again, six from the 44.
Anderson will throw.
And intercepted.
Intercepted. Never really got that return cranking, but the
didn't get a return, but we get the ball back at our 30.
Nice job.
DBs have been on one this year. And Miami's fans are realizing it. Hoodie man, Devin Grant came back for his senior year. Makes the play and then falls down.
The Orange have the ball back and ready to go to work. That last drive really productive. David wound up with a touchdown. They'll try to do it again.
Yeah, so I don't expect this offense to change too much, Reese. They had a great drive. They got the touchdown. Everything working. I would expect them to keep
Ari Hatcher in motion.
And just imagine if they could put another touchdown on the board right here. They could.
And to Justice Ross Simmons. Ross Simmons gets a block from the Quinn Allen up to the 50, fighting to the 48.
Has him on the move, and he gets it all the way to the 48-yard line.
And that's just a great individual effort by the wide receiver. He catches this ball way short of the sticks, but because he's able to make the defender miss, now he's able to get the extra yards and turn that into an explosive play.
They go to the ground.
Allen.
Shakes off the defender.
Gain of three.
I like feeding my guy. I like getting my running back touches, feeding the ball so he can break some of those big runs, but I'm also okay with these little ones. Set the tone, stay balanced.
After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line second and seven. Quarterback touch pass on the
touch pass to Amari Hatcher. Hatcher, gain of three.
And these little touch passes, man, they're just the easiest completions ever for quarterbacks. Palmer, I bet you would have loved being able to just flick a four. That counts as
with 42
percentage, which is good. And then it's all right after the catch, so pretty easy for a QB.
You wouldn't have been the only All-American in this
game. And over to Clement. Clement tries making a juke, and it doesn't work, but he gets the first down to the 34, and that ends the quarter.
Guys, we're at the end of the quarter, and Syracuse has the lead. We've played one. Before we move on, let's have a look at the stats.
And Sebastian is, well, doing some flips.
Back at it to open the quarter with this first down play. Looking to move it through the air.
Ross Simmons catch up to the 17, first down.
Finally get him down after a terrific pickup.
His fourth catch of the day.
To work with another first down. Fast motion from
Ari Hatcher in motion.
Touch pass on the run.
Allen does pick up a block, and Amari Hatcher gets tackled down for a gain of seven.
Second and three.
Well, and on these little push passes, timing is so important. You're trying to snap it right as he's getting a full head of steam. When he gets the ball, he's hitting the outside. David, he puts the defense in such a difficult spot.
You immediately have to be rotating when you see that motion.
So Allen can't get by.
That's why offenses love to run. It just makes the defense communicate and see if you can just get him out of the spot.
I like the play call on offense. I like
it. Just really hoping we could get Quinn Allen by there. Defense was ready. That would have been a good.
Quick pass on the fly motion.
And nothing doing. And we're going to send Jay Noe out for.
It's fourth down, and they'll try the field goal.
Field goal, and it is up and good.
And that will extend their lead even further.
As we go up 10-0, can't score.
So after the made field goal, they'll kick it away and rely on their defense.
Can't score a touchdown, but. We do extend our lead. Michigan's up on New Mexico. And quick throw. And loss of one. Aiden Brown makes the tackle. Look at an 11. 7 minutes remaining here, and yeah, we do get the ball start. It's a run. Ripped up Goose Chestnut. Makes the tackle. Makes it first down. First and 10, though. So, I'm sorry, that was Jaden Bellamy. And another good run. Down.
Defense in press coverage.
And inches, man in motion.
On the move, it's Fletcher.
And Bellamy again cut down, cuts Fletcher down.
I think that can be really frustrating for a defense. You're in your own end, you want to create some space, second and inches, trying to get physical, but can't get physical enough to get the first down. Now it's third down. What do you do now?
He gets the first down. They ran right past the blitz.
I don't need it to be pretty. I just need my inches.
Oh, man. That's frustrating. Could have forced a punt there. First and 10. Another run. Brings them down this time for a game of one.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine.
Second and nine. 4:25 remaining.
Give to the single back.
And
they'll bring him down after a short pickup.
And a lot of times you want those big plays. You want those splash plays. But sometimes you're going to take some losses. You're not going to run the football overly well. But if you continue to run it, you can at least create some balance.
Makes it for third and six.
Otherwise, you're just going to abandon it. And now
QB power. Slowest QB in the world. As we die. He realized he's in Miami. Does Devin Grant realize he's in Miami? I don't think so. Another run. And gain of one. Isaiah Hastings on the tackle. No, I don't think Devin Grant realizes he's in Miami. And another run. And tackled third and two. And brought down fourth and three. A punt from the 34 from Miami. We go to the 2 minute warning, and now they want to go for it.
Warning, and this thing has been one-sided, and they hope to at least have something to feel good about going into halftime. A field goal try would have been a 51 yarder. They'll opt instead to try to move the chains on fourth down. Got it into the end zone.
Tell you what, that passing touchdown, man, that should spark this whole team. Like, the comeback is more than on now. Like, they got.
And we now have a 3-point game.
Go into the half, get all the juices, all the excitement, and be like, listen,
here in South Beach.
We got this. The comeback's in full effect.
On the run from inside his own.
Work can't make anything happen. I don't know why I bother trying to make returns, because.
Heads back onto the field. Always good to get points on a drive, David, but chip shot field goals can leave you a little empty.
Right.
I think it's great to get points, but the great teams get touchdowns in the red area. You got to get out there this time and execute a little better on this drive.
You're absolutely right, David. Generally, the best red zone offenses are the ones that run the ball the best. So let's see if they can be a little bit more physical on this drive.
Lowry again. And out of bounds. 36.
After that completion to the air on first down,
Lamet taken out after a gain of seven,
and he goes out of bounds after a nice pickup on that one.
A nice job by the defense there, tackling the catch and smothering the tight end. They know this offense is going to try to find him in the passing game in a lot of different situations. That time, perfect coverage.
Mari Hatcher motions
big guy down, not easy to do.
He wants to throw it again.
And dropped.
The pass is incomplete. All right. Loose by the hip. Come to the line at the 42, facing a third and short. They'll try to get the first through the air.
First down and more across the 50.
But not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
That was, by the way, that drop was Braden Davis's first incompletion.
Little touch pass to the receiver.
Hatcher, gain of two.
On that one, second and eight coming up. Syracuse right back at it. The give to the back. Nice, solid form tackle from this sophomore.
We call our first time out there.
Better find the earplugs. Here comes the noise. Backing this defense on third down.
And caught. Ooh.
Third down conversions are huge, and they've got one, and they're at the 35.
To the 35.
From the gun, running back gets to give.
Allen, gain of five the hard way.
Equals a first down every couple of carries, so don't forget about the run game.
Having to run a long way to gain 5 yards.
Davis will throw.
First down, Ross Simmons. Ross Simmons breaks a tackle. Touchdown, Justice Ross Simmons.
What a grab and go for the score.
One of the reasons this offense is so exciting to watch, they've got guys that are dangerous after the catch. If this quarterback gets through his progression, David, hits you in stride, these guys will take it to the house.
Man, it's your job to do the rest, right? You hit me in stride where I don't have to stop running. I don't have to break down. It makes it so easy, the connection between quarterback, wide
even,
receiver. You can
even if we can't take the big chunk play with Amari Hatcher in motion, which did work so many times last year.
He'll try to tack on one more.
There's always somebody open on that play. 85 yards in a minute 19, minute 22 apparently.
Kevin Connors, Kevin, what do you got?
All right, guys, a little update on what else is happening in college football.
And Jaden's kick is deep.
Wake Forest is
and kneel down. Forest is up 17. Nothing against Kennesaw State. 34 ticks left here.
Big happens you should know about.
And how about that one? Kevin will be keeping an eye
on. And three.
See what they've got on second down.
5, 4, 3. Do they do snap it?
Unloads to the wideout.
And taken down quick though.
They make the stop, and that is the end of
the ends the half, and we get the ball.
Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Guys, who's got a better seat there in South Florida than you? A captivating start to this one. And we have to start this halftime breakdown by addressing the play of this elite wide receiver. This is clearly a young man who, once he's finished playing on Saturdays, he's going to be playing on Sundays. The kid has different gears. He has a knack for finding gaps in the defense. And I can't remember a college player with that kind of catch radius. With that said, let's send it back to the guys in the shadows of South Beach.
All right, Kevin, about ready to get things cranked back.
So we come back here to South Beach. We start with the ball. Touchdown here would be huge. Rourke gets it.
He'll bring it back from inside his five.
And up to the 19.
Defensively, you understand, like, the running game isn't a big part of the plan. I wonder how they adjust and play more.
No gain there.
Yeah, so you're going to have to be ready if you're a quarterback. You know, you're probably going to see some different coverages. You might see a little bit more blitz in the second half as well. So you have to know where your answers are.
We can make the screen work here.
It's second and 10. Trying to get to it.
Or not.
He was hit just as he was releasing the pass, and it falls to the ground incomplete.
And finally, the defense is able to get some pressure on this quarterback. They have been trying all game long different ways to affect him. Weren't able to.
Lowry is open. He's taken that role of Ron Gadsden of always open. And first down up to the 38.
Third down, offenses have their plays. What they like in third short, what they like third medium, third long. Great job by the offense.
Our offensive line just can't run block. We're so. We're just so irrelevant in terms of run blocking.
Play expecting run, and they just dominated up front. Beat their one-on-one.
Also one for the Quinn Allen.
Quick pass on the jet motion.
And gain of one there.
Progress made there on the short run.
Etcher in motion.
Davis looking to pass.
Zeed Haynes makes the catch. And first down.
With that one, and they've got enough for the first down.
This is exactly why third down is practiced every single day. Third and short, third and medium.
Just in 10 from the 46 of Miami.
You got to lock in. Great success by the offense so far.
And a three for the Quinn Allen.
Offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
Second and seven from the 43.
It's a draw.
Draw gains five. Pass is deflected.
Gotta give the defense credit on that play, taking everything away, forcing the incompletion. Now it's decision time. Fourth and short, and you're in field goal range. What do you do here?
They really have no choice here. This is a no-brainer.
The 55-yard field goal.
He'll try to throw and pick up the first down.
And incomplete.
Oh
my God. It's just what's frustrating about having a team that, like, we can't run this year, it seems.
They believe they can run right here.
And loss of three. Dayton Bellamy on the tackle.
Not what they had in mind to start this drive. Here comes second and 13.
And 13.
They'll go right back to the run.
And Grant on the tackle there.
Exciting, but it's not exciting to get 5 or 6 yards and pop on the ground, but it will be very successful.
Third and eight.
Anderson wants to throw. Pressure coming.
Fumble, ball's on the ground, and McDonald picks it up as he's taking Anderson to the ground. That's a goofy shot of Otto. Derek McDonald.
Sack, even better if you get the ball.
And I like the awareness of this defender on the play.
Ball
because
up.
He might not actually.
Ball was on the ground. Where's our young man playing down lineman? Early spin move. Just fights off the man. And the best thing of this strip sack. He doesn't even... As Anderson's running away, just drops it. McDonald picks it up with one hand as he's taking the quarterback down. Ball! And we have the ball.
The hit, but he was able to still swat away, use those long arms to create the turnover.
The 21 of Miami.
On the move.
Allen running through to the 9.
Before they pick up the big first down. So, so close to cashing it in for this offense. They'll dial up the run on first and goal. Touchdown, Orange!
And the Quinn Allen scores again.
Another rushing touchdown. That's now 2 on the game.
His second day. It's the score of the day.
Running the ball, being the more physical team, and they look like it right now.
We're up 23-7. Senior came back after winning the Heisman. Hasn't had a great start to the year.
One more onto that lead. And with the extra point, they now have a 3 possession lead at 17.
Doing what he can to get it done.
Stayed in front of them when they took over possession, but they wasted no time. Couple of
and
into the end zone.
Take us away, and it will be a touchback. 4:25 remaining here in the quarter.
Here comes the Hurricane offense looking to gather a little more strength. Trailing now by 17, David. This is an opportunity that they need to
interception. Jaden Bellamy, house call.
Takes it the other way. Touchdown, Cuse. And this defense coming up with points of their own. What an interception return. What a play by this defense with
the
pick
on the
six.
Quick screen, Jaden Bellamy, our best DB, breaks it and scores.
We turn to offense, go lay some blocks so my guy can get it and take it back to the house.
And our kicker, they know, is starting to get a workout.
And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further.
Now go up 31-7.
They'll kick it off and send that defense right back out there to try to score again after the pick six.
Picks away and will once again be a touchback.
He thought about bringing that out for
4:19 remaining.
Take a knee and they'll bring it to the 25. And here comes that Miami offense back onto the field. They face a pretty tall mountain here, Jesse, down 24. But if they're going to climb it, this is a good time to start.
Sense of urgency. And Fletcher right cut down after a gain of 9.
David, they've got to score on this drive. Obviously, their defense needs to get stops, but at this point, offensively, they've got to execute much better.
They got to be super aggressive. Down 24, you're going to need 3 touchdowns, 3 2
points. And incomplete.
Everything to kind of go your way, so fast and throwing the football.
And this offense can ill afford to come up empty on this drive already.
It's like 3rd and 1.
Possessions. They'll try to get it through the air.
Get it to the tight end and a first down.
It's a game of first down. And they've got one out to their own 37. The Canes come to the line with a fresh set of downs.
First and 10.
From the gun,
run.
Pose their running game.
They had Hastings and forced them back. And they do gain 1.
It's grammatically correct to say a team is being out physical. You hear it a lot in football, though. That's happening in this game. They are just not getting the push they need all game long up front to have any success.
Offside.
Decide to run it.
McDonald's foot was on the line. It was across the line.
That's all about.
Offside.
Could be a first down for Miami. They will decline the penalty.
Plenty happy enough with the result of that play, so they just let the official put that flag back in his pocket and decline the penalty. So after the flag, a fresh set of downs.
A little too eager, too tight to the line.
Give to the running back.
Bellamy misses the tackle. Gain of 2.
On that one. 2nd and 8 coming up.
That's a really good job by the defense.
Allen.
Them up, getting them on the ground. Take away that run game. Make them one-dimensional. Put them in passing.
2nd and 8.
Really good job by the defense.
They'll try the
run. Bellamy, first contact. And gain of 4, 5 for...
It's going to make 3rd down easy. You're not
trying to hit a home run. Miami, and it's third and three now.
Now you know, third down, everything's on the table, everything's available.
And in motion. It's another run. And first down.
A chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end. They're in the red zone, first and 10 from the 20. Trying to cap this drive with a pass. Throws toward the end zone.
Interception.
And it is another
interception number 3. And this one will be a touchback if it stands. I would imagine we're going to get a review there. Marcus Washington Jr., his first year starting.
It's such tight windows to throw in. Great job by the defender breaking on the ball, creating the interception.
They don't review it.
The Orange have the ball back and ready to go to work.
Not that I'm complaining. I'm just kind of caught off guard.
And this has been a dream game for this play caller too, right? It's like anything that he's calling is working flawlessly.
Yeah, it's fun to be the offensive coordinator, but not the defensive coordinator. They have.
And we're gonna go to the fourth quarter.
Absolutely miserable day trying to solve the riddle of this offense.
Guys, we're at the end of the quarter, and Syracuse has the lead. And they've built a comfortable lead after three.
We've built ourselves a very comfortable lead. Kind of just bullying Miami.
As we start the fourth quarter, it'll take a pretty sizable comeback to win this one.
Second and 6.
We'll get this quarter going with a second down play. Hand off to the lone back.
And loss of 2 for the Quinn Allen.
Getting stops like what they just did. Be interesting to see what the offense does on this next one.
If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. On third down, going up top.
Valari, first down, and some more up to the 40.
Really confident throw and catch there. Big pickup, and they have a first down. And now a fresh set of downs for this offense.
Former Michigan quarterback Dan Valari. Amari Hatcher can't get the edge, loss of 3.
Backwards after that completion, not the way they had it drawn up.
And that's just an example of the defense having a better play call than you have on offense. I like the creativity offensively, but how about the defense having their cornerback in position to make the play?
Davis will throw.
Allen catches it, and first down.
Keeps piling up numbers with completion after completion in this standout performance.
As we cross midfield, and we are going to start taking the air out of the ball a little bit.
You just say, I'm just going to keep doing me. And what I do with this offense is throw the football.
And Yason Willis, who's just not, I mean,
they bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Don't you love energetic defenses that fly around and make things?
We've been struggling all year so far to make.
There is nowhere to go. Nice job by the defense creating the tackle for a loss on first down.
They think there's room to run to the right here.
And gain of 3 for Allen.
This junior knows how to get him on the ground. Trying to have a big completion here.
And interception thrown by Braden Davis.
And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception.
The most frustrating thing I see in football is when teams give up and they quit and they wave the white flag.
We just couldn't.
You're on the field. Your job is to stop them. It doesn't matter what the scoreboard is.
And Bellamy forces the receiver out of bounds. We're going into a 3-man rush.
On second down, he'll let it fly. He makes the connection.
That's first down.
Down immediately, but
I need to find anything with at least 4 pass rushers. I do not want Anderson just to be comfortable here.
He's looking to throw it.
And throw away.
Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again.
Second and 10. 5:38 remaining.
Looking downfield, it's Anderson. Got his man out.
And gain of 2.
Make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit of time to get to that first down marker. A third and long.
Third and very long. Miami needs it. They need to go for it too.
From the gun, wants to pass. Feeling some.
Fumble again, picked up by an offensive lineman. Going backwards. Worse than 25.
Make sure you keep possession. Coach has no choice here. The offense has to stay on the field, down multiple possessions this late. Fourth down attempt coming. He's going to let
interception again.
Another interception. This guy just can't find his own players. The return never really got started, but boy, he has set his team up at the 20.
Aiden Gold this time.
The Syracuse offense heads back onto the field. Boy, they had that last drive moving a little bit, David, but then the mistake just crushed them.
Yeah, and those mistakes are going to happen. You're going to throw the football, you're going to throw interceptions. But I think I stay aggressive with this offense. I get back to what I did in the first part of that drive, what made me successful.
I agree, David. Just turn the page if you're a quarterback, right? On this drive, you did a lot of good things there leading up to that pick. Forget about it. Move on. Play the next play.
They'll keep it on the ground to keep
Allen, gain of 4.
Stopped at the 32. That's a gain of 4. They're facing a third down. They'll try the left side.
Allen's gonna get it. He leaves stayed in bounds too. As Miami fans haven't left yet, me too. Now we did
a
lot of bounds, and now Ihsan Willis is going
to
get a carry. Gain of 2.
And the defense doing a great job committing to the run. When you commit to the run like this, obviously you can give up some plays in the passing game, but you got to stop the run first.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. Looking for space. It's Allen
has room. Loops around and to the 40. That's a first down.
But he's got 15 yards on that one and a first down.
As he approaches 80 yards.
Down in this game, they just can't do anything to stop this offense at this point, David. Right now,
as we are going
to
wait for the 2 minute warning, I lied.
It seems they can do.
Yeah, and it's frustrating. I got to sell out.
Allen fighting first down. Second and 4.
The football is only going to run this thing out quicker. I got to find a way to
and
strip the football.
Another first down for the Quinn Allen.
They're just about to put this W in the books, guys. Comes against a ranked opponent, a team that most
as
of
we're
expected them to beat, and they were able to come.
Going
to
get our first ranked win of the season.
It's fun to play other
first and 10 from the 28. Minute 43. It doesn't look like Miami's going to.
They're probably going to continue to climb up the charts, handling their business early in the season against a pretty dang good team.
And I think at the end of the year, when the committee's meeting together and they're deciding which teams are going to reach the playoff, this is a game they're going to point back to.
And Valari is TE1 this year with Noah Ron Gadsden.
They won the game. They took care of business. This was impressive.
And Allen does get. Over 100. We can get the first down here with our real fullback, who's wearing number 9, by the way. First down, and
this is one of those weeks when you watch tape, it's going to be really fun to watch it. Not like when you get beat up. A lot of big plays from this offense.
So with the late lead, they're ready.
As we can finally kneel it down. In victory formation, our first ranked win. This isn't entirely realistic because let's be honest, there would be no Miami fans here.
They've got a solid drive working, but now looking at second and 11.
And done. Game, set, and match. A big win to go to 2-0. Braden Davis had himself another good game. Just the one interception. LaQuinn Allen gets player of the game. Is your player of the game? Is that right there? Is Miami's only offensive touchdown? I think Miami's only points. 31-7. This one was a lot more comfortable than Notre Dame. 31-7. How many interceptions has four interceptions, the one fumble lost. I believe that's Ben Isaac. Reached his top five, were first. Taylor Wilson's reached his top five, were first. Barry Ogunjobi reached his top five, were first. Miles Good has reached his top five, were first. Quarterback from Buffalo and a quarterback from Piscataway, New Jersey. Barry Mowring reached his top five, were first. We have three QBs right now. Charlie Johnson reached his top five, we were seventh. Eric Guzman's reached his top five, we're first. Stan Maddox reached his top five, we're first. Charlie Joseph has reached his top five. We're first. My thumb's starting to get tired. Greg Allen has reached his top five. We're first. Like, my logic with all of these quarterbacks is one of them's going to come to Syracuse. Von Parms reached his top four. His top eight. We're second. Ooh. Talia Poe reached his top eight. We're locked out. We were 10th. Ooh. Forrest Berry has reached his top eight. We are second. Behind Purdue. Ooh. Dennis Yeast has reached his top eight. We're third. Ooh. Alec October has reached his top eight. We're first. And Terrence Hippenhammer has reached his top eight. We're first. This is a class right here. That could be a potential class. We come to see if you have both. Both attempts combined, ooh. People want to play for Turbo Yoda. As we finally play a home game. Player of the Week here in... Conference Player of the Week in Derek McDonald. Devin Grant, two ACC Defensive Player of the Week and Devin Grant Week 0 and then Derek McDonald. Week one. Through an early Heisman watch. Check. Antoine Wells. Caden Salter. Reuben Owens. Jim Miller. And Ashton Jonte. Do some quick recruiting. We have 5 hours. We got some back. Get your hand on my phone charger, bud. Puppy. Well, we can take Charlie Johnson off our board. Not that's gonna get us any hours back. And Poe. Well. We have a fullback. Forrest Berry, athlete for what? Throw power, so probably a QB. Turn him into like a running back or a receiver though, because he can zoom. Who do we want to start taking some away from? Maybe Washington. No. Yeah, you can do that. Max here. Yeah, you can do that. It took me a little bit to figure it out too, admittedly. Who do we want to schedule a visit? Let's go to Isaac. We don't know much about what he likes, is a problem. So we'll go with family visit. There's our recruiting. Before we play game two, I'm gonna get up real quick, go to the bathroom, everything, and we will get game two underway. So thank you for hanging out. We'll see you on the other side of this break. We can run some ads too. Just wear our generic homes and a game that it's a basketball rivalry. We played UConn in year one. We beat them. This is a basketball rivalry. This game is weird, and for the first time all year. Welcome to the most depressing place in college football. Our third game of the season.
Guys, can't wait to get this one started.
And we'll be kicking the ball off, buddy. No, I'm sorry, buddy.
We'll kick off and we'll be underway.
No. You're gonna get hurt. No. Yeah, it does do recruiting for you. This kicks in the air. And will be a touchback.
And he'll just take a knee and this drive will start at the 25.
And we see Nick Evers again. Hi, Nick. Man. Why does this game exist? As the Carrier Dome is rocking. I'm out in the pistol. Nick Evers is running. He gets a first down.
They better be able to find a way to get pressure on him, because if they don't, this is going to be a long day.
They'll snap it from the 36. They've got a first down.
Let's just make Nick Evers' life miserable. Gain of one.
And they capitalize on name, image, and likeness, and teams are in different conferences.
Again, nine.
The biggest thing, and the thing that keeps
Evers drops raw loss of yards. Loss of five. This is a drops back to throw, and he got taken down immediately off the draw. Third and 14. Evers running, throwing, drops harmlessly to the turf. This punt is away. Burke gets it. And up to the 30. And making his home debut is Braden Davis. When Allen's back after winning the Heisman.
Generally set the tone for their response.
And gain of five for Allen on the first play.
The teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
Halfway there on first down, it's second and five.
Second and five. Touch pass to Amari Hatcher. Hatcher gets the corner around the defensive end and steps down up to the 49.
It's so important this offense is able to get this guy the ball in space, especially on the perimeter of the field. And I love that last play call because he's able to get outside and use his speed.
Hatcher in motion.
This guy is most dangerous.
And misses Ross Simmons.
That's a ball that this offense should be able to complete. They had the coverage they wanted.
We usually complete those. It's not very often we miss that, but we do.
To the left.
Allen, gain of eight.
Third and two.
Yassan Willis in now, unfortunately.
Great job finishing with his pads.
Willis gets the first down.
Listen, the offensive line has to do their job, but a really good job by the running back, understanding where his hole is. Go hit it, get the first down, don't mess around. Nice job following his hole, getting positive yards.
Getting some heat.
And to Dan Villari. Villari for the 14.
The sweet, catch is plenty to give him a first down.
Well, this time got size and he's got some athleticism, and he's very difficult to cover.
Now we're in red zone inside the 15. And off to Allen. Allen sprinting, makes one man miss, and up to the two.
Offense, they get this guy going early in the game, and they're doing a nice job of that right now. Remember, he's the kind of running back who gets better.
And we're going to take a little bit of time off, and Allen runs through a man. Hey, why are you looking at my computer?
The offense goes as he does, so really no surprise in the opening drive.
Touchdown, the Quinn Allen. Down to my dog is licking my computer like a weirdo. Wouldn't want to be UConn today. Probably not. Do you want to be UConn any day?
They'll try to add another to their lead.
And that kick was a missile. Field goals up and good, or points up and good. Now Jaden O. Kick is away. Viril will kneel it down.
Something you want to say very often. You don't want the punter out there. This offense needs to get back lathered
no
up
game.
And get a little bit more of a rhythm.
Best way to do that, identify where your best players are and just get them the football. Give these guys some touches.
Second and 10. Nick Evers back there. And it's a run. Gain of one. Hastings on the tackle.
And these defensive tackles just eat people. They swallow human beings when you get near them. They're so big. Strong.
Third and nine. Evers throwing. It's his drop. And out comes the punter again. Butts. Boots. Punter wearing 17. And it's away.
Bork
cannot use his speed. Let's go big right off the bat.
How about the way they
attack? See if we can go big right off the bat. Hatcher motions. Wants it all. Brayden Davis wanted it. Unfortunately, there wasn't enough space, but first down to the 36.
With guys one-on-one on islands in the perimeter of the field, and they're just going to have to make better plays than what we saw right there. They knew this offense was going to try to be aggressive.
Allen, first down, run, gain of five.
They get him stopped at the 30, but not before he gets 5 yards.
And after having a nice game like that on first down, for the offensive coordinator here, maybe you're thinking about being aggressive and taking a shot. Because even if it's incomplete on second,
on third, wanted to get a little trickery there, and well, that was kind of dumb.
They might be fortunate it wasn't knocked free for a fumble. It'll be third down.
Third and five from the 30.
If they go back to the air after the incompletion, it's third and five. Davis looking to pass.
Davis intercepted. Whoa.
He can be dangerous with the ball in his hands, with no room to return that kick.
A wasted drive there. A rare mistake from Brayden Davis so far this year. Get to the tailback and first down. That's the best play that UConn's had.
They're getting this guy lathered up. Bulldozes him. Finally stopped at the 46 after a 15-yard gain. They've come out with answers on this possession and now another first down. He's going to pass. Fires one high and deep.
Okay, UConn. UConn's awake now.
They are finding soft spots in this defense. He's got it down to the 25. UConn comes to the line after getting another first down. Running back searching for a hole.
And no gain.
Will be stopped for no gain.
How about the defender being a heat seeking missile.
Second and 10.
Radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some.
And Evers cut down after a gain of two. Seven ticks left. Three, two, one.
He's just going to have to do a good job of
understanding the quarter.
When to hand it off, when to pitch it, and try to keep this defense on their heels and read his keys. He's got a lot of talent. He's got to make sure he's making the right decisions moving forward.
Well, Darrell Robinson, really just a bad interception is
Get things started here in the second. Back on the field after the break, and we'll start the quarter here on third down.
Got UConn from life. And pass is broken up. Really, just as long as we don't.
He needs to make sure those mechanics are pure from the right hash and 40 yards away.
Kick is up. No good. Kicker wearing 13. We're just going to see a lot of weird numbers this game, aren't we? Allen, gain of two.
Especially in this game, if you're going to win, and David, they've got to be able to eliminate the mental mistakes.
Yeah, and I don't think you get conservative or play it safe. You can trust your guy. I think you.
Alabama's up three on UNL Monroe. UL Monroe.
On the run, it's Allen.
Allen.
They get him stopped after gain of
three.
Looking for that first down on third.
Gotta find 5 yards here.
On the gun, wants to pass.
Fires
to the big fella.
Gain of two.
It's going to be just short of the first down. It's going to bring up a decision for this coach.
It's a really nice job in coverage defensively there, because that tight end, he wasn't really even open. Quarterback just still tried to put it on him and give him an opportunity, but great tackle, short of the stick, setting up fourth down.
Finally,
just because it's UConn. Only because it's UConn.
A lot about their confidence in this quarterback. Fourth down early in the game on your own end, and you go for it. But when you make decisions and throws like that,
right,
you need to see why.
It's first and 10 from the 38-yard line. They'll leave it with him.
And can't get around. Loss of five.
Chance they knock him down for a loss of five.
They're trying to run the football. There's just nowhere to go for the ball carrier inside. He tried to bounce it to the outside. That linebacker way too fast.
No. A pass to Amari Hatcher. Hatcher has a lot of room. And up to the 44. First down.
It's so hard for a defense to have to stop plays like that, because it really forces you to play with great eye discipline. You see the pre-snap motion. Defense doesn't know if he's just running across the field and he's going to run a route, if he's going to block, or if he has the football. That time, he was able to outflank the defense and hurt them to get that first
down. And first down, Amari Hatcher.
And chunk plays are the name of the game, and they get one here before the defense finally makes the stop. After that huge play, right back at him on first and 10.
First and 10 from the 12.
Wide receiver coming across in motion. Touch pass on the jet sweep.
Jet sweep, gain of 8.
World of opportunities on second and 2.
That's a really good job.
Second and 2.
Reacting to what they see the quarterback flip it forward on the touch pass. Now I got to go get it, right?
5:37 remaining.
Picked up some yards, yeah.
Allen, gain of 1.
Now you have to make him earn it now on the next down.
We're in range of our kicker, Jaden O.
To defend a big third down in the red zone. They'll stick to the ground.
Allen fighting forward. Honda McCord is gone.
First and goal for this offense. Defense is backed up.
Honda McCord was a senior in year one. He is very much gone.
Pushes for the goal.
And Quinn Allen dives in. It's a touchdown. Touchdown number 2 for Allen.
This guy just has a nose for the end zone. And you love
yeah, Honda McCord is gone. He is in the NFL.
In the open field and go score. He's been really good for his offense early this year.
Maybe.
His fifth rushing touchdown on the season.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead.
Extra points up and good.
Extra point pushes the lead to 14.
We go up 14. Michigan and Oklahoma tied 7-7. 4:28 here remaining in this quarter, but in this game. Bano's kick deep. 7:28 remaining in Michigan, Oklahoma. That game will be interesting because, well, Michigan's defending champ is the one seed. Or is it, not the one seed. The is ranked number one. And gain a four.
Don't be afraid to dial up plays that you've already had success with, running it and throwing it. It's okay to repeat plays down 14 at this point.
And I would also say, Palmer, kind of understanding that my defense is not
raw.
Great. So I know offensively,
first down.
Good possessions together here, make something happen on this side of the football.
Well, I know this is an offensive line that has a ton of pride, and they want to come out each and every game and really impose their will on the D-line. They got just
play action.
He lost one down the sideline.
What? I actually have seen it.
Quarterback knew exactly where he wanted to go with the football, had time, spins the ball deep. Nice job by this offense, understanding what the defense is giving them and creating the explosive play.
Going to the running game.
As they lose three there. I've seen it via sim engine.
Surprised, honestly, he held on to the football. That is what you want. You want physical knockback.
And gain of 10 makes it third and three.
Coaches like, is the running back falling forward? If he's falling forward, we're not doing our job.
And 2-minute warning. Yeah, you do have hope.
We made our way to the 2-minute warning, and now they'll try to at least cut a little something off of this lead before the break. Wants to throw on third down. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
And we have another field goal attempt from Neil Lawrence.
Through his progressions, there was just simply nobody open. Couldn't make an accurate enough throw. Ball falls incomplete.
Now long and in. Makes it.
And the kicker delivers the three ball to finish off the drive.
14-3. I mean, the only reason I know is because I played in the playoff. Year one, and Rourke from a couple yards deep.
Coming out with it, it's Rourke.
Up and doing.
Any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Orange have the ball back and ready to go.
I love how the AI could score off of
It sure was, and that's why this offense is so dangerous, David, because they can score in a hurry because of how efficient they are throwing the football.
And welcome to modern
Ferrari gain of
spread you out, find my playmakers, make quick decisions, and really put
seven
difficult situations.
All three timeouts, we can we do get the ball back, by the way. First down for Allen.
Drag down to the turf, but not before getting the first down.
This is an offense that really sees their identity as being able to run the football. Nice job there picking up the first down.
It'll be first and 10 from the 30. Will jet sweep pass?
Umari Hatcher has space. Umari Hatcher can't. Oh, man.
How many ways can I get to my guys who can fly, who are playmakers, and let them make big plays? This is another one you've seen. Catch the football, flip it ahead really quickly, get it to a burner, going full speed across the formation. He gets the edge, makes the big play.
They'll throw it on first down.
This is Ross Simmons, first down, and a few more up to the 19.
This offense told us coming in they were going to challenge this secondary early and often. They were going to use their speed to their advantage and take advantage of this quarterback's touch and arm talent. And they already in the second quarter, they've got over 200 yards thrown.
On Willis, going to get not quite to the first down marker.
I want to get my running backs the ball in space as much as possible. And sometimes it doesn't work in the running game, but I can throw it to him. Can try to create some space out wide, dump him the football, let him make
and Umari Hatcher's in.
Hallelujah land.
Okay.
It's still early, but we have some real distance being put on the
as we go up 21-3, 41 seconds.
Right now everything find something positive quick.
And let's check in with Kevin Connors in the studio. Kevin,
dynamite matchup today, fellas. Let's show you what's going down.
Number 25 Nebraska is trailing to Akron.
That quarterback just needs to show the poise of a young Tommy Frazier, and they are right back in this. It's a touchdown game. They're trailing by 7.
41 ticks here remaining in the half. And Evers sacked, fumbled, but on ground. Derek McDonald recovers it. Isaiah Hastings on the sack. First and 10 from the 10.
Getting him on the ground and getting the football out of the way.
And touchdown. Wayne Allen, your Heisman winner, your defending Heisman winner, Heisman champion, Heisman winner, strikes the pose after his third touchdown of the game. Heisman winner, yeah, that. Jay No getting a workout in as we now extend the lead. A reminder, we get the ball to start the half.
And they thought about a return, then thought better of it. They'll bring it out to the 25. UConn going back to work on offense. So late in the half, this is really an opportunity, David, maybe to swing the momentum in their favor.
First down, timeout called.
If we're a little bit down, listen, I just think this is a point with the offense that they can prove. Like, we're here, we're going to create something now that we can build on in the second half.
Coach said all week he wanted to be aggressive. This is a great opportunity to show that.
Loopy
right
snap
now.
Animation, and balls flung out of bounds. The white tent.
And the incompletion brings up a second down. He's looking to throw. Pulls it in. It's
and timeout called after gain of 3-4.
To find a way to get more points on the board before the half.
Well, we knew coming into this game, this offense was
Dane Bellamy delivered a shot to Nick Evers, by the way.
Here they are just finding an easy completion. It's not a touchdown, but they just want to get this guy lathered up.
Will be a first down up to the 50 and another timeout.
Timeout on the field. Tight game here late in the first half.
15 seconds. Tight game. Not quite.
First down.
As thrown out of bounds.
Too much adrenaline on that throw. Never gave his receiver a chance. Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. Looking to throw on second down.
And that's thrown away.
To avoid the negative play and just get rid of that thing.
Things just not going as easy for this guy as they did his last game out. Last time he completed over 70% of his throws. This week, though,
third and 10.
He's taken some throws away. They've made some plays. He just hasn't been quite spot on.
Fourth and 10.
He's going to have to play better.
We're going to go to prevent.
And you knew he was going to take a step back because you can't throw the ball for over 80% the season. Like, that's ridiculous. Last week,
fourth and 10 from the 50.
He's freezing cold, and he's got to find something.
As long as we don't give up the touchdown, I don't care what happens.
Somebody needs to step up, make a play, and maybe.
And we go to halftime.
First half in the books. Time now to join Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
When Allen having himself a game, 54 yards on 13 carries, 3 scores.
Talk about a first half from that dude out of the backfield. He's been a total game changer. How many top plays moments have we seen on missed tackles alone? Video game moves from one of the shiftiest players in all of college football. And with that, let's send it back to the guys inside the dome in lovely Central New York.
Thanks for that breakdown, Kevin. UConn has it teed up to start Nick. This second half.
A couple yards deep again for Rourke.
He'll bring it out. It's Rourke. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Syracuse offense heads back onto the field. This offense has really been clicking in the game so far, Jesse.
No doubt. Everything their play caller is dialing up, these guys offensively have been...
See what we can do here against...
Just maintaining the lead. keep doing what you've been doing. You got a big lead. Let's just keep piling it on until they find an answer.
And a two.
Just a solid stop by this sophomore. And now on second down for this offense.
And an eight. We can eventually get at least the offensive starters once again.
Davis will throw a little release to the back. He's there to make the stop and
good play.
Reverse losing yardage.
We lose a couple yards.
This linebacker is a special player because not only is he good making tackles in the open field, this guy can cover, and you saw a great example of it with that running back.
You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20.
Once again, get the...
From the gun, wants to pass.
Ross Simmons.
Caught close to the marker.
Ross Simmons up to the 38, first down.
Go out of bounds, and this aerial attack just continues to carve this defense into tiny slices. Syracuse ready to go to work with another first down.
And a two for Allen.
Give him two on that one. Second and eight coming up. Stuck with a running game on first down. Now here they come again. Here we go. The give to the back.
And first down across the 50.
Across the 50 into the 46-yard line. It'll be first down.
In halftime in this locker room, there was a lot of positive things to talk about. You got the lead. But you know what else will be positive, Palmer? Get the running game going early in this second half.
You're absolutely right here. And I
on Willis this time runs over a man.
Let these guys
first down.
This thing over, be physical and push this defense around.
Second down, second and three, gain of seven.
The football, but if you can pound it away and get these kind of gains, they will just add up. Where the defense
also two.
Get first downs and ultimately get some points. Yeah, and listen, the offense has had their way, and they've had so much success and so much production. But listen, at least the defense got a rep. You know, maybe this gets you some a spark. Maybe
a second interception for Brayden Davis, and Quinn Allen makes the tackle.
Terms of where he was going with the ball, just don't like the accuracy. That was not good location on the throw. Got away from him a little bit, and the defense able to come up with a big pick.
Isaiah Hastings doing back there in coverage.
Pick up, but a little bit short of the first down. Second down coming up.
McIntyre trying to get the crowd into it, and Grant on the tackle. Third and one. Oh, this is bad.
Wide open downfield. The expressway is wide open. Touchdown, Huskies. And once he found daylight, it was Katie bar the door, baby. Great example of how a second half can really change everything for a team.
No doubt. First half looked bad. It looked like it was bleak. It looked like it was ugly. But now you're
okay. Well, that's not good.
More drives like
not
this.
What we wanted to do there.
About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll bring it out. It's Rourke. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. The Orange have the ball back.
Davis off his second interception of the day.
Going to pick on the last drive. Need to take care of the ball this time, Jesse.
We're going to find out. And it's a seven for Allen.
Fight through adversity after that last drive.
Yeah, clear the mechanism, move on. That's a part of it, right? You're going to be a great player. You got to learn how to handle these mistakes and move on.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's second and three. And they try to run inside, and there is nowhere to go.
Nothing doing there.
Good job and contained by this defense. And in order to do that, the
it's a third and three.
Scrimmage defensively has got to be able to set the point. And, force
and to Clement
back into traffic.
Running breaks through one tackle up to the 31.
Really try to get this drive going. Good execution on third down as they have it first and 10 at the 31.
And from the 31.
After the completion, making sure they have good balance.
I don't know why it gave me precision spin, but
when he loses four on the carry,
they're trying to run the ball on first down, guys, but just nothing doing up.
Nothing doing there. Ran right into a blitz, essentially.
Up on that play, there was nowhere for that guy to go.
And maybe they want to try somewhere
offensive line. Our run blocking is just so pathetic.
I think he's counting to make sure there's only 11 guys on defense.
Man, not going to get much. Definitely not going to get enough.
Lumber to stop him from getting the first down. Syracuse will send out the punt team. They'll have to punt for the first time this afternoon.
Our first punt of the day.
He will not make a fair catch.
And up to the 29.
Bring it back. And he's going to get it up to about the 29-yard line before he's brought down. The UConn.
We need to make some plays here.
This is a real chance to sort of settle things down, maybe generate a little momentum if you can put together a touchdown drive here. That would be a great opportunity. A great opportunity to make a statement and get back in this thing. I mean, it hasn't gone your way early, but I feel like you're creating some momentum here. And a score, Jesse, a score makes this a fun ball game.
It would be huge, but it's on the offense. They have to look at each other right now in this huddle on the field and go, look, guys, it's on us to march this ball down the field, score some points, and bring some energy now to our sideline.
It's first and 10 from the 38-yard line.
Bellamy makes a tackle after a gain of two.
And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short game. They'll line up for a second down play.
Like an eight. 26 ticks remaining here.
He's looking to throw. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there. Still a little ground to cover. Pick up the first. Here on third down.
Third and four. 2-1 quarter.
Guys, we're at the end of the quarter, and Syracuse has the
18.
Lead. They built a comfortable lead after three quarters of play. Let's take a look at how we got
just
here.
Just some bad play from Braden Davis today. Two interceptions.
One more period to go, and we'll see just how much fight they've got left in them.
Got it.
We've got this third down play to open the quarter. From the gun, wants to pass.
Interception. Goose Chestnut.
He was looking for room to return.
Needed a play. And there it is, right there. 4 seconds away.
Are trying to do this. Pad them stats, get the INT. Nice job by this D.
So no room to run there, and you wonder after that loss on first down where they turn now.
Yeah, and that's why it's so important for the defense to win these first downs, right? You want to create
also one
to make this offense so much more predictable.
Mari Hatcher's able to cut up field, gain of 10.
Well, in that down and distance, you're probably expecting them to throw it way down the field to get the first. Instead, they go push pass, and they did catch the defense off guard. And even though that was a pretty explosive play, David, they still didn't have enough yards to get it.
Well, and catch me off guard is relative. That's what you would say, the offensive player. I would say, listen, we're playing a little bit deeper because we're not going to get
Allen gets the first down. Short stuff. The 33.
It's a quick, easy pass from the offense. Rally up, make the play, live to fight another down.
Maybe this will breathe a little life into this offense, which has been flat.
Getting away from the blitz and 9-10 yards there from Allen.
Kept it on the ground on first down. See if they stick with that plan on second. Out of the gun, the running back
gets it and first down.
Enough to give Syracuse the first down.
I love when players understand.
Carry from Jaden Hart.
And they understand where the first down marker is, and they understand where I got to get to. A lot of people you'll see run north south and try to bounce out wide and make big
plays. Allen cuts up first down.
Sometimes it's about getting that first down to make sure I get an extra set of downs instead of trying to make
one of these times I'm actually going
to
call this.
Ready to go to work with another first down.
I've kept audibling into a inside zone
to the ground. He's got it again.
Allen gain of 5. He crosses over the 100 yard mark there.
Game before the defense gets him down. Halfway there on first down, it's second and 5.
This might be the time we do get the ball to Amari Hatcher.
Wide receiver shows motion. Touch pass on the jet.
It is. They've got it up to the 28.
They'll mark it at the 28. It's first down.
And these touch passes, it's so hard because there's always action off of it, right? If I fake this pass and I can run it up the gut, or I can throw it and I just spread me out and make me defend so many things, and you could tell.
First and 10 from the 28.
Got the big first down.
Halfway through the fourth quarter. Not quite halfway through the fourth quarter, I should say. LA Gitch is really bad.
Try to get it to the edge.
Allen fighting, gain of three.
Browns 3 yards out of that one somehow. It's second and seven.
A small gain, I know. But again, the defense knows he's going to run the football. He's willing to run the football, not just drop back and pass. Make him honor the run game. You got to do a lot of this.
Ross Simmons, first down and more, up to the seven. Shoved out of bounds.
Yeah, and way to be creative, way to get the ball in the perimeter really quickly, get some speed outside. All you got to do is secure that edge, and you're just trying to get that first down. Nice job, nice play call by the offense.
Quick touch pass to the receiver.
Hatcher, gain of two.
Form tackle from this sophomore. Picked up some of what they needed on first down. Now it's second and goal from the five. Fast motion from the offense. Receiver on the move gets the touchdown.
Simmons. Gain of two.
And he just continues to put up numbers, and that number is now over 300.
As Braden Davis does go over 300 yards.
He's to touch the ground. He's back there. He's making the right reads right now.
And Allen scores for the fourth time. As that should bury UConn officially.
Young fella. You know why they handed him the ball a lot? Because he did that. That's his fourth trip to pay dirt.
As we will go up 25.
What a great back. And four touchdowns on the deck.
The AT unit on the field. And the extra point splits the uprights, and they're up 35-10.
We are going to do this here at the end of the game. In the event we do get the ball back, which we probably will. Son Willis is gonna get some more touches. Jaden Hart's gonna get some touches. Possibly our freshman back Gary McCourt will get some touches too. Hard to say. And Carlos Del Rio Wilson will also get some touches. We'll get. And there we go. Now we will up 25 with 3:35 remaining. It's because up 35-14.
Kennesaw State is in the unusual position of having to come from behind right now, but there's not a soul who doesn't believe they can't pull this off.
Kennesaw State's in the unusual position from coming behind.
To the Sharks.
Oh, they're playing an FCS team. Please, somebody on defense at least make a tackle.
Thanks for the update on that one. Kevin, let us know when it goes final.
First and 10. Just under 3 minutes. Taken down.
Man, as he took a shot trying to deliver that football, and it'll be second down.
And 10.
That kind of day for this quarterback.
Nick Evers takes a shot.
Never been able to get into a rhythm throwing the football. Timing's been off. Accuracy hasn't been great. We've seen some drops. Just not in sync, and that's why they
and gain of six makes it third and four.
Really nice job by the quarterback understanding I need to throw this ball hard, like I gotta fit in there tight, and a nice job by the wide receiver wearing it.
Interception. Deuce Chestnut again, and up to the nine. That does officially end the game.
Bring on the nickel defense. You know they're passing the football for
plays just like that to make the INT almost put this one away.
Without some of our backups.
Back onto the field.
Let's see, Hassan Willis runs over a man to gain 8.
Be a sledgehammer. He's got it out to the 16.
And how good does that feel, right? You've got to go. In the fourth quarter. The defense knows you're going to try to run the ball to ice the game, and you rip off an 8-yard run. They know it's coming, and they still can't.
Amari Hatcher is going to get the touch here.
Puts it ahead quickly to the receiver.
He goes backwards a couple yards.
This offense has a lot of different ways they can attack you. You're going to see the entire playbook.
Amari Hatcher, 186 yards.
And getting guys the ball out on the perimeter. Great job.
Off to Willis, gain of 1.
Ahead a bit before he's brought down.
And I'm a fan of this, man. Run the football, eat the clock. We got the lead. This offense has put together a nice day, man. Like, just balance, rhythm, timing, play calling, everything has worked. That's why they built this lead. They've had a great day today.
They're in motion.
They'll run the ball. The
on Willis, gain of 4.
Whatever it takes to get that ball up to the 32. How bold will they be on third down after that last run?
Marty Hatcher is still going to be the man getting this ball. We're going to go inside zone. They moved that
on the run, it's
safety up, and we get the first down. That's going to be...
They'll have a first down as they mark it at the 40.
Well, that's kind of the advantage of third and medium, right? Is the defense, you keep them guessing. You could throw it, you can run it. That time they hand it off, and they pick it up.
Yeah, and you can see the D drop back a little bit. It creates a little bit of space. The running back blasts through, gets the first down.
Looks as if we
have an injury to Bryce Yates of UConn.
Now on second down.
Somebody that isn't Amari Hatcher is going to touch this ball on a touch pass.
Quarterback touch pass on the jet sweep.
Or Pena, who was wide receiver 2-ish here. Just never. Progress like everybody else. Senior, he's behind some guys. He will take this game 3-0. See what happened in some other games. We will not have to snap this. And that is the game.
When you know you have a team outclassed, the ability to play to that standard and finish with a blowout.
Brandon Davis made a couple mistakes. Like that was his first real bad game with Clint Allen's play as your player of the game 2 weeks in a row.
This was so easy. Great execution. Just beat down in every facet.
Had a couple mistakes from Brandon Davis, the 2 interceptions. A blemish on an otherwise 300-yard day. Defense played good. Only gave up 10.
That's gonna do it for us.
And well, UConn was never in the game.
I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another.
Well, hey, we had ourselves a good session. Advance a week, see what we get in terms of recruiting recruiting stuff. We'll look at those again. Get a minute. Jared Knox has reached his top 4. We're first. Jeff Garrison's reached his top 4. We're fifth. Or top 5 and we're fifth. Both of them UConn for the Natty. Hey, good luck with that for them. Garrison's reached his top 5. We're fifth. Javier Chamberlain reached his top 5. We're sitting at 5th. Joey Story reached his top 5. We're 3rd. Robbie Triplewitz Triplewitz. That last name was top five, we're fifth. And Cooper Hicks reached his top five, we're third. So, when we're here next, we're going to be seeing UConn, who's 0-2. UConn, we're going to be seeing Clemson, who's 0-2 at Clemson.